This is Deborah Atkinson, and you're listening to Flipping 50, Seaside, I might add, where I address your top questions and struggles. I share what to eat and how to move and how to think to get the energy and the vitality you want in the second and better half. So I have a super treat for you today, and if it's a little noisy and it sounds like there's waves or beach, you're going to have to deal with it because we are seaside in Cozumel, and I am with my dear friend Dexter Yates, who I met 2 years ago, and I've been tracking her and stalking her, or as good as that, ever since. And I ran into her in the lobby as I arrived this afternoon. We got to talking, and we're actually going to pick up on a topic that I've been sharing with you about your thoughts and your mindset. But before we do that, let me remind you, Dexter Yates is now 74. She last month in Kona, as many of you might know who've been on my Facebook page at Flipping 50, was the oldest female who did Kona, the World Championship Ironman Triathlon. Last year, for those of you who are a little less familiar, I'm assuming a lot, I realize, if you're not into triathlon, but here she is. So I met her when she was only 72. Now she's 74. She's back here to do Cozumel with me, and most likely she is more ready and trained than I am. So I will probably be eating her dust on Sunday. Dexter, thanks so much for taking a few minutes.
Oh, well, it's a pleasure. Thank you for asking me.
When I just love your whole story and your motivation and the fact that you're out there and doing all that you're doing, showing everyone that it has nothing to do with age, it's everything to do with ability and mindset, which is
yes,
really where our conversation this afternoon came up. So I want to dive into that before we both forget, because my blood sugar is low and I'm ready for dinner. We were talking about the book I've shared with many of you Flipping 50 listeners, that You Are the Placebo by Dr. Joe Dispenza. And the whole idea was, I'd asked Dexter, have you read that? And, you know, mindset is such a big deal. And I already knew that it was with her just from having a 5-minute conversation with this woman. You can catch that that's the truth. And the idea is that I was banking on as of this morning is, you know, I'm really very, very undertrained and my endurance has not been good. And although I hate to blame it on mold, I'm seriously wondering if that's a piece of it. But I also think I can't think about that between now and Sunday, that what I have to think about is what I want and what the picture of that race looks like and how I want to feel while I'm doing it. So I've really been diving into it. Our conversation got started that way, as I said, have you read that? And she shared that back in
1989,
way before probably Dr. Joe Dispenza even got out of high school, she was already doing this visioning. So talk a little bit about what it is that you did.
Okay. I was at Kona for the World Championship, and at that point I was a spectator, and I was standing at the finish line and watching runners run towards the finish line with their heads held high, their arms swinging, and big smiles on their face. And they would cross the finish line and drop like a rag doll or a puppet whose strings had been cut. It amazed me. And I thought about it, and I thought they must have been visualizing the finish line for a very long time. And when they got there, they had no memories or no mindset of what they were going to do after that. It was about 4 or 5 years later that I was able to qualify and go to do that race. It had been a dream of mine for many years. When I qualified, and perhaps even before, I visualized the entire race every night before I would go to bed. And I would lay in bed and I would picture the start line. I would picture how I was going to feel getting in the water. And at that point, my mind was very creative. I would imagine what the water would feel like, what it would smell like, and the sounds I would hear. And I would visualize the swim, and then I would visualize getting out and getting on my bike, and I would visualize the entire bike ride, just to every detail that I could possibly put into it. And again, I would visualize the run. But one of the things that I really made a point to do was, as I came down the road to the finish line, I would visualize my head being held high and my stride being strong, but I would visualize right past the finish line and what I would do after I finished, because I did not want to be one of those rag dolls collapsing in a heap at the finish line. So I visualized the next things that I would do, which at that particular race is you go, you get your medal, you get your picture taken, and then you can go to the massage tent and get a massage. So I, every evening, would visualize the entire race and this process of going to get a massage. In my visualization, usually I would be laying in bed in a quiet place, and during the visualization and getting the massage, I would drift off to sleep. And for months, this is how I would sleep each and every night. So come my race day, I crossed the finish line and everything went just as I had visualized and mentally pictured for all of these months. And I laid down on the massage table, and the next thing I remembered was waking up in my hotel room. I have no recollection to this day how I got from that massage table to my hotel room. It is a complete blank. I don't even know how I got there. So the visualization and mental picturing and imagining something that you're going to do is an amazing, powerful tool.
I love that. And actually, as you were talking, I think what a great analogy to, you know, anybody out there who's thinking, you know, I want to lose weight, you know, and I know that that may be a focus. Maybe it's not a triathlon at all versus an Ironman. But often when you are picturing that, you're only picturing what that looks like for a moment, for a minute in time, as opposed to what it's going to do for you. Or think of all the people who are thinking about retirement. They're actually thinking about the last day they'll go to work. They're not actually thinking about what's
next. The next day, or the next week, or what they want it to look like. And I think that you don't want to go to your last day of work and come home and collapse like a rag doll. You
know,
you want to have that next step, whatever it is. If it's travel, you want to visualize the places you want to go and make them real in your mind.
So good. So good. I love that. So, of course, I'm going to be, knock on wood, I'm going to be tapping into that visualization for other reasons, but I'll be putting that to work. I'll let you know how that goes.
Oh, come on. You want to go to Kona?
Oh, I'd love to go to Kona. I need to kick a few other women out of my age group first.
So, yeah, I know.
tell me what your year's been like. And more importantly, we're talking about what's after this. What's next year look like?
Next year is exciting. I have two races that I have entered already, both full Ironmans. And one of them is a race I have never been to and really don't know that much about. But the group that I travel with is going there, so I'm going to go along with them and be traveling with friends, and I will visualize as much as I can a successful race. And then after that, I'm actually going to race in Canada, which was the very first Ironman race I ever did, Penticton, and I'm totally excited about that, and I know the course. I have done it. And I will definitely be visualizing that entire course. And so I'm looking forward to that. If things go well on Sunday for this race, I'm hoping to qualify again for Kona. So that may be on my agenda for next year. And then,
just another ho-hum trip to Hawaii.
Yes, I know. It's a tough life. And I also really think that I will come back here again next year because I enjoy this race.
Yes.
And I totally love the people I meet here too.
Back at you. And that was my next question. I wanted to ask you, what's your feeling about this race in Cozumel? I mean, what's the draw? Why do you like it?
I love the course. I think it's very well suited for me. Mm-hmm. And especially now that I am, you know, a senior athlete, it is a wonderful group of people here, the support during the race. And there's something, maybe you agree with me, with the group that we travel with. And here, for some reason, you see and meet more people. It's just a wonderful gathering place. It's warm. And I live in North Idaho, and winter is there, and summer is here. So I kind of get to revisit summer for a week or two before diving back into the whole winter situation.
It's such a great comment about it. It is the people.
It is.
The whole Ironman experience, or triathlon, I think you could talk about any length,
yes,
is really about the people. It's a supportive community of people, and it does not matter if you're a beginner, if you are the last person, you're the first person, somewhere in the middle. It's everyone at that starting line is experiencing the same feelings, the same trepidation or excitement, and it's a shared community.
It is a community. It definitely is a community. And through social media, I have met and I have several friends that are Facebook friends who I have never met in person that I'm looking forward to meeting here. And as I have done more races, I accumulate more friends that I meet, and we stay in touch, and it makes you feel like you have your own family, you know, your tri family. So
when is your birthday, by the way?
In August.
Okay. So you've got a half year left. So
yes,
you are not, girlfriend, the typical right now 75-year-old.
No.
So what is that like when you're at home, when you're not among your triathlon friends who think, yes, this is great, but we also think that's what I'm striving for. I want to be you when I'm 75. What is it like to be around other people who maybe are not in this? This is not in their blood and not what they do. How are you accepted?
Most of the people that I see and socialize with, I meet people at the pool. I live out of town on a small piece of property, so we're pretty isolated from our neighbors. And but I do come to town, and when I come to town, there's people at the pool that I meet. I have some friends who swimming 500 yards is a total workout for them, and they admire what I'm doing. We're friends. We talk. We go to lunch together, and we're just people. They don't think that, you know, I'm anything special. We're just special friends. And then there, you know, you'll go to the grocery store, and I may have an Ironman shirt on, and the clerk at the grocery store will go, "Wow, you do Ironman." We do have an Ironman in our community, so they are aware of what it is. And of course, one of the questions that I do frequently get asked is, "How old are you?" And, you know, it's not a problem for me to say I'm 74 years old. And I do believe they respect that I am doing that race at this age. So, you know, it's good. It's good.
So what would you say to somebody who's in their 60s or 50s, for that matter, not to mention their 70s, who's thinking that they've never done that before, that it's too late to start, that that's just a big piece to bite off?
What would I say?
What would you say to them?
I would say, if you want to, you can do it. There is work involved. But if it's not something that you don't want to do, what do you want to do? And do it. Maybe you want to be a dancer. Go learn how to be a dancer. If, you know, whatever it is that you want to do, pursue it. Don't, there's no reason not to. My favorite mantra or quote is, don't let what you can't do keep you from what you can do, whatever it might be. If it's something you want or inspired to try it. That's kind of my feelings.
Such great advice. And I have a vision right now that we probably are not done with this conversation yet this weekend, but we are going to end with that thought and take ourselves to dinner.
So, oh, sounds good to me.
Listeners, if you have a question for Dexter that I missed, please leave it below the show link at flipping50.com/Cozumel. And I love to hear from you. If this episode was helpful or inspiring, please leave a rating in iTunes and then share it with a friend. Surround yourself with a supportive community of women on the same journey. To get the most from this week's episode, again, check out today's show notes at flipping50.com/Cozumel, where you'll find some pictures and some links to some of the races that Dexter has done. And so you'll know a little bit more about what we're talking about. What are you waiting for? Let's start flipping 50 together.